শ্রীমতে রামানুজায় নমঃ। We see the world, which is full of imbalances, and also realize our responsibility to balance the abnormities and cleavages of the world with our continuous and sensational effort. To be different and divided is the nature of the world, and nature of a civilized man and community is to level up these imbalances and to create harmony and unity in this society. And in this act, there are three persons who are responsible for that. We used to call it in the act of charity as triple G. The first G is known as the God, who is the ultimate responsible agent for that. Second thing is the government, which should take care of the society and equality of the society by all means. And third thing is a good-hearted person who should create a proper government as well as environment inside the society and provoke God inside himself to see that the world is balanced. So God, government and a good-hearted community, this combines and prepares a system of triad which is known as triple G, which makes the society to get into equality. And after the government, we are having a responsibility as NGOs, we used to call non-governmental organizations. But we used to define it in a different sense. They are known as nano-governmental organizations.
Oh.
A government which is a federation of very few powerful agencies trampling on the heads of the other people is always dangerous to the society. That should be checked and balances by innumerable units of nano frequencies that exist in each and every non-governmental unit. We used to call it as also neo-governmental organization. Apart from the system of democracy or any other political institutionalization which forms a government, there are innumerable neo-governments. That is, there are lot of governments that are appearing new fashion of social responsibility, mutuality, understanding and removing of friction and promotion of fraternity for common identity and social security and development. So we used to call NGOs as nano-government units and neo-government units, more than that of non-governmental units. They are not non-governmental. They are the same governmental units in the disguise of a social platform or social uniform. So this is what we call the NGO, what we define here. So NGOs have three major things. Any NGO just promoting the society is overruling or violating the rules of NGO. It is a duty of the government to take care of the society. Any NGO should be having the primary duty of demanding the government that taxes act and that success and get its own self-development and dynastic development. So the immediate responsibility of any NGO is to see that the government and its funds, the persons elected with promises, with pseudo-promises and pre-supplantations, they are squeezed and crushed with the net by a democratic push and pull so that they implement their duties in the society with fear and more liability towards answering the public response. So first is to create a demand of getting the government done all of its own responsible and liable activities. Second is to join with the government. Third is a wonderful right. If an NGO cannot see the government where it can demand or join and work with, immediately the government should be deorganized and reorganized in a super standard structure by means of which there can be a collateral and compatible bondage between society, NGOs and government. Ask from the government. If there is any unavoidable reason, join with the government. If a government cannot be either joined nor demanded, such a government should be reconstituted by the democratic will of NGOs by kindling the awareness and consensus of the public. So this is what we call NGO, and we have wider responsibilities to cover, and we are having a very slow journey. Hope that we will reach it within a decade and do something wonderful. And innumerable NGOs are there. You know that now more than the public population, NGO population is more. Somebody has created a very great research. Competing with the number of qualitative enrichment is different. Quantitatively, innumerable people are there. So we have HelpAge India, the Indian Promotion Council is there, South Asian Development, it is being done. Innumerable people, nowadays a patient for everybody to have a foundation. Whether they have any inner foundation or not, they should have a foundation. Like Rockefeller Foundation, Bill Gates Foundation, Ford Foundation, Infosys Foundation, Time Foundation. So innumerable foundations are there, and Oxfam International, innumerable such societies are there. But we should understand the privilege, prestige and pride of our institution, and also how to incorporate more prestige and how to safeguard the integrity of our own institution and to enrich the valor, glamour and color of it. So we have three things. One is to know about ourselves, and second is to enrich the status, third is to guard our own institution, from the forthcoming ills and evils which are awaiting to penetrate inside. And this is known as institutional custodianship or institutional safeguardingness that we should develop here. And you know that there is a system which we call active benevolence. Everybody has mercy inside. I have never seen a person who cannot control his tears on seeing a movie or a TV serial. Everybody is crying like that. So naturally, even the cruelest person has a spot or a droplet or a pinch of mercy and affection inside. But why it is not being matured and nurtured in a practical shape so that it comes for social rescue? So active benevolence, what is NGO? We have mercy, but to integrate the mercy of different people and comfort the rescue of the society is the work of NGO. Already existing mercy, different people in different quantum that could be unified for a common purpose, like a lens for the sun's rays. NGO is a lens for the rays of mercy and diligence that exists with all the social members. And just as it has been designed and defined by both the Melvin Jones in 1917, who founded this institution and who claimed that everybody and the talent should be put together for improving the communities. It is known as active benevolence. Even the recent system, even the recent most claim that has been quoted by Eberhard Jewitz, who is the present international president, he quoted that very simple, whatever that is in the Shastras, Dharman Chara. More than knowledge, you should apply it. And more than mere willingness, you should do it. The same sentence has been quoted by a foreigner. We are having that quotation within ourselves for the past several millennia without knowing the meaning and implementation technique are the same. So this is known as what we call NGO, to have active benevolence. I am limited. I am ignorant. I am impotent. I am helpless. But the greatness of the world is, if several impotents unite together, they create potency. If several ignorants unite together, that is the blazing light of knowledge or intellect. If several helpless people unite together, they can help the other people in the society. That is known as the power of conglomeration, the power of identity, integrity and unity. And NGO is a person which is nothing but not unit of stronger people. It is unit of weaker people to create strength within themselves to take care of the other weaker denizens of the society and their associates. That is known as NGO. And there should be a particular focus in our services, which we call, now we are having Site First in our system. Site First that has contributed to more than 30 million of people, giving initial vision. There are three types of vision. If you cannot see, initially you are blind. If you cannot see the sufferings of the society, you are selectively blind. If you can see the suffering and cannot do anything, that is executive blindness, you are also blind in that country. And considering the history of the Lions Club, we used to know that Helen Keller, while attending the Federation of Lions in the year 1925 at Ohio, she addressed that this Lions or this Federation, they are the knights of the blind in the crusades against darkness. That was a statement. And we should also understand the pride. See, whenever you understand the pride of a seat in which you are sitting, one, you will be feeling shameful or reluctant to sit inside. Second, you will have the courage to qualify yourself so that you can sit in the seat and ride in the same pathway. And this is what we want from that. So we should understand that we are also one among the prestigious members of the drafting committee of the United Nations Charter. So this type of greatness that we are possessing, that should be activated in the second brain, as I have already told. In youth movements, like we are having a lot of things like peace contest. We are having innumerable peace poster concepts in our youth systems, and also youth campaigns and exchange of ideas and technology has been also implemented. We are also having Lion Quest systems. So innumerable things that are being introduced by the international people that has resulted in the formation of not only recognition in the year 1925 and United Charter, in the year of 2007, prestigiously we know that it has been awarded as the first NGO by the Financial Analyst. So what we have to understand is, number one, how to enrich it more. Number two, how to bring the same pride to our own region. Three, how to work with other talents. I always want to say for Indian NGOs like Lions that you have to get the technology and valor of the best, and you have to get the culture and integrity of the East. So complete Indianization in NGOs like Lions is impossible and unnecessary, and complete Westernization is very dangerous, and it is very disruptive to that of our own identity, of our culture and heritage. So it is the duty of each and every person governing that council to establish the greatness of our culture and deal with how it can be done. And coming to the conclusion, I want to say each and everything or any institution is governed with five components. One is the area where we work. We cannot simultaneously work in all areas. Area where we work, what we need or the society needs, what is the social literacy or response from the mindset of the people, what is the political rule and the political collaboration or cooperation possible. Fifth is leadership qualities. If your person is a capable leader, he can work even in a desert. Even amidst a paradise, a non-qualified leader or a person with incompatible members of the society fighting for power and chair with that people, nobody can achieve anything at all. These five components have to be understood. And coming to the nomenclature of Lions, somebody asked me, well, I was telling that I am addressing Lions Club. Everybody was surprised because I am very new and alienistic to this platform. You can see me. Somebody asked why they are called as Lions. Then it was that in the Shastras, we used to have a specified or specific nomenclature. Like somebody called as forest, Vidyaranya, the forest of knowledge. Vidya Sagara, the ocean of knowledge. And we used to call somebody Giri, Parvata, mountain. So calling somebody as mountain is for majesty. Ocean is for the unfathomability. Calling somebody as forest is for the depth and density that they possess. So here we used to also have Simha, Vyagra and Rishabha. For great people, committed people, working people, dynamic people, they used to call them as Simha. I used to say that always India is the primogenitor for Lions Club because it has established lot of people. Now, whatever the people name as Singh and Sinha, they are all belonging to the Lions Cub, even not Lions Club. So we have our own history that India has the pioneership for Lions Club, number one. And number two, we should understand there are two things. One is absolute nature. Second is descriptive or executive nature. If somebody is Vidyaranya or Vidyasagara, ocean of knowledge, it means that number one, the absolute nature is knowledge. And the descriptive thing is known as being in ocean. Like that, if somebody is called as a lion, that is not absolute nature of anybody. Absolute nature is different. Compassion, altruism, cosmopolitanism is the absolute nature, which springs from qualities like love, mercy, compassion and service. This is absolute nature. Lion is a qualifying additional name which says that that person in that commitment, he is honest. So a lion is a person who is honest. So a lion is a person who is steadfast. Lion is a person who is having endurance. I'm talking about ideal lion. So any person who is having the endurance, any person having integrity, any person having unity, any person having moral courage, any person having diligence, any person having some sort of submission, surrender and sacrifice, such a person is known as Lion. And one more thing, I want to also attribute the pride to Lions Club. Lions Club or the name Lions to a club or an international NGO that has created a new dictionary for bravery. In traditional history, bravery means nothing but attacking enemies. Attacking enemies who are visualizable and those who are conspicuous. Those enemies who are coming with weapons and other people, attacking them is known as bravery. Lions Club or the Lions system has only given a new name to bravery, not only attacking the visible people or evil elements, but attacking silent, subtle, small, crawling social evils like poverty, unemployment, disabilities, political corruption and all other social subtle evils. They are not only the enemies across the border. There are lot of inner enemies within us and around us, beyond us. Those things are considered and bravery has been specially branded with a new description by the Lions International. Second thing is, destruction of enemies is considered to be bravery by tradition, but Lions has proved that construction of the society is a real bravery. So it is a new definition for the Lions that has been given. And we want to prove that this idealism should be implanted within us. And there are members of society which we call spark. How great institutions come? By a spark of a small person, somebody nourish and nurture the community, somebody develop the community, somebody shield the community and spread the community. There are a lot of people to dilute the community, divert the community and dilapidate the community. We should understand who are there. And by integrity within our own self, because you know that we are having a lot of problems with our own brothers, in the form of case suits and files. We are having diseases inside us, so enemies need not be across borders or outside us. Yes. We should understand how inner enmity and internal enmity can be removed by dialogue, mutual realization, affection and social integrity, giving them a commitment. That is a very great challenge to people like all of us. We are having 8 major issues according to Shastra. Generally they say, whatever you speak, there is a difference between your speech and action. Action and your impact. Impact and self-propellingness. We used to say that any person continuously providing help to a second person is an idiot. He's a useless person. He's cruel. Making that person self-propelling to take care of himself and take care of his own dependence is real charity. And we should see if our impact is not going to change or metamorphose into some sort of social constructivity by self-propellingness, that is a very great danger to a charitable activity. And we should be not only dealing with the emergent occasion, we should be available for casual things. Regarding blindness, there are a lot of things. Intrauterine problems are there, and also malnutrition problems are there. There are very many external and exogenetic influential factors are there. So we should deal with the preventive factors along with curative factors. We should be casually serving the people instead of going there by emergency, just as the politically elected people, they go for emergency and election. We should not behave like that. We should have a constant shower of our care instead of occasional shower and going somewhere else. We should not be having diverted things but directed things. Instead of having a half meal in 10 areas, if you have a small pinch or part of thing in a directed vision, it will have more power, it will have more effulgence, radiance and brilliance, and that is what we have to provide here. And coming to the real conclusion, we used to have lot of projections in wherever a community is there. They have analyzed lot of communities. There is a very great research about NGOs and their projections. There are 8 unwanted projections in NGOs. Number one, in the pretext of NGOs, there are lot of NGOs where fiscal mishandling is there. Second thing, conversions are being done in the pretext of NGOs and social services. And terrorism, disruptivism is silently served in few NGOs. Fourth thing, lobbying and prime leadership and membership relation making, that is happening in NGOs. There are no NGOs exempted, or it is an unavoidable thing, so lobbying is there. Second thing is business relations that are happening, image projection and publicity, that is also a thing, but it is less harmful. It is not going to harm anybody, but it is diverting you from the prime mission. And other two things are, each and everybody is feeling a loneliness. They cannot hug with gold and silver. Even the relations are not so embraceable, so they want an outlet and they want to fulfill their loneliness is their mutuality and understanding the society. And final thing, apart from this type of relation, they want some entertainment and relaxation. These 8 things are known as substandard projections in NGOs. Social service is the main one. All the other things, salubrious things I am quoting, those things can happen as byproducts, and you should not be totally oriented, and these things should not make other things valuable and vital things to be sacrificed at any cost. And this is the advice to any NGO I want to say. And finally, international theme is that yesterday I addressed a media club where I told that anything will have a solution only if it is internationally projected, because we are approaching a global village. Any problem of you should become an international attention, it should draw international association, it should draw also international support for you. If you make it international for your problems, there will be an international response and pressurization so that you can get the benefit. And Lions Club, being an international club, there are a lot of opportunities for taking all the problems as not only an individual problem, but the whole problem to human community, not only a human problem, but to the existence of life in the world itself, not only to this world, but also the whole planetary and universal system, not only to a nation and its provisional binding, but also towards the international atmosphere, not only pertaining to today, but also the futuristic and security of the prospective forthcoming generations of our life. So this international platform should be very much configured and invigorated by each and everybody's presence. Each and everybody is a lion, and Shastra says that each and everybody is having the valor and commitment inside, and that should be some sort of motivation from speakers, some inspirers, some doers, motivators and exercises and principal personalities. And this motivation should be unextinguishably preserved forever. After crossing the threshold of Savera, we should not forget everything. We should have it in mind and have an eternal flame of knowledge and burning for service. I wish and bless the present governor. He is more blessed, because this is the first time in my life I am addressing such type of conferences. And it is a very smart and sharp and small transit visit. I have to immediately rush. And I wish and bless each and everybody to get more revelation of their inner awareness. Each and everybody is noble by nature or innation. I wish each and everybody to realize themselves and relish the power of integrity and common holding and action. And I wish success in each and every inch of attempt of all of you in the proper manner, bringing happiness and harmony in the society. Education we have to work, health we have to work, harmony we have to work, human rights we have to work, and leading science and technology in the proper direction is also our duty. And uprooting this corruption and bringing good governance is our main thing. If we are corrupt, unless we are corrupt, we won't be silent or supporting these things at all. If we are supporting these things, if we are not against these things, then immediately we should be either corrupt or we should be in poverty. So we should realize our greatness and bring transformation to society. I wish that the lot of the Lions Club is there. There are 1.3 million of people with 48,000 clubs having 205 countries. The establishment. And you know that if there is a possibility if this land section and division can bring a transformation leading a pioneer shift to all the other existing 1.29999 members of the society in millions, then it will be a greater blessing. I wish and bless success to all of you once again, and I extend my prayers to the Almighty to extend His choices, shower of blessings to potentialize you for your activities to bring individual characteristic molding and public behavior and social license. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.